resources they need. And unfortunately, Utah has one of the highest rates of sex crime in the United States. If you see that yellow line, that is where the United States falls right now in terms of sex crimes per 100,000 of the population. And that blue line? Yep, that's Utah. We're not exactly in a good spot right now. And it seems like there's some lack of sex education that might be responsible for that. So, a little about me. I am from Washington. You see that in the bottom left? Yep, that's me. I'm from Seattle, the rainy city, and I love it. But about 5 years ago, I moved to Utah for nursing school and for other reasons. And I have made a lot of friends who are from Utah. Well, in Washington, my experience with sex education was what I considered pretty normal. I started getting sex ed in 5th and 6th grade, learning about puberty and bodily changes. Made sense. And my parents supplemented that with sex education that I had in the home. I had the talk at age 10 or 11, and I had continual talks after that to make sure that I understood what sex was, what was happening in my body, and what was important to know as I was growing older. I thought it was great. But again, my Utah friends, they didn't seem to know that. They didn't seem to know basic things about their own anatomy, and that bothered me. So when I got together with my group here at UVU, my bachelor's level nursing group, we decided to do a community education project on sex ed for adolescents in Utah. So here we are, and you are watching this video. So let's go over some basic definitions first. What is sex? So when we say sex, it can mean a few different things, but in this case, we're talking about sexual intercourse. And even that has many definitions. As you can see in this diagram, I kind of showed a few ways that sex can be represented. Traditionally, sex has meant the penis going into the vagina, and that's called penile-vaginal sex. That's your pretty traditional definition of sex, but that doesn't really give much room for people who are not cisgender and heterosexual. So there can be homosexual sexual acts. And there can also be other forms, such as masturbation, which is self-stimulation, or other things too. There's a wide range of definitions for sex, so we won't necessarily narrow it down to just one definition, but those things are good to know as well. So, basic female anatomy, and I'm going to pull out a laser pointer here. So, the thing that most people talk about is the vagina. So the vagina is down here, and it's the one that opens up to the external bodily cavity. And that's the thing that you put tampons up, ladies. And then that connects to the uterus, which is where the egg comes from here. Every month, if you're regular, if you have a regular menstruation cycle, the egg will come up here into the fallopian tube, boom, pop in the uterus. There are some people who have various conditions where this doesn't happen or they have less frequent periods, but ideally, this is what happens. This is also, if an egg gets fertilized, oftentimes it'll get fertilized in the fallopian tube, and then the fertilized egg will end up in the uterus, which is where implantation happens and a baby starts to form. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go over the male anatomy. And this is some basic stuff. I'm not going to go into huge detail like this diagram has, but it has some good information. So, down here is the testicle. That's where a lot of the sperm is formed. And that, once it's formed, which, by the way, is millions and millions per day, comes up this blue tube, which isn't blue in real life, I promise, and can be excreted through the urethra. That is also the same tube that males urinate through. And they don't usually come out at the same time. Basic anatomy makes only one come out at a time, but it's still the same hole. So, going back over basic anatomy, women have 3 holes. That includes their anus, as well as their vagina, and their urethra. But men only have the 2 holes. They have the anus and the urethra. Not necessarily super important, but it's kind of good to know. So, why is any of this we're talking about relevant? So, like I said before, many teens still choose to have sex. I'm not going to attribute any good or bad to that. I'm sure you've gotten plenty of that from those around you. But 30% of teens are still having sex, so that means that they're still being exposed to whatever risks sex may have. And that can be emotional risks, that can be social risks, that can be physical and biological risks. There's a lot of risks here. So biological risks could obviously be STIs, meaning sexually transmitted infections, and those can have potentially no effect, or they can be potentially very dangerous if left untreated over long periods of time. There can be social effects. If some people find out that you had sex, there can be social ostracization, or on the flip side, some teens are pressured to have sex in order to fit in. Among those who have sex, there's also the risk of, guess what, teen pregnancy. And that's probably something that you've been told your whole life. Oh, if you have sex, you're going to get pregnant. Well, not necessarily. But if that does happen to a young adolescent female, the rates of her being able to graduate from high school are down to about 40%. So, let's be honest, if you want to have a career someday, if you want to go to college, and if you're participating in risky sexual activity and unprotected sex, the rates of you being able to graduate from high school are going down. So, just something to keep in mind. Sexual crimes here in Utah and sexual abuse are at an all-time high compared to the rest of the U.S., and many experts believe that this is related to poor sexual education. So, like I said, I'm not going to tell you what you should or shouldn't do, but I want you to be aware of what sex might entail. So, how do you know when you're ready for sex? Well, there's no age, there's no time in life, but here are a few basic rules of thumb. First of all, do you have the means to find out how to protect yourself from a pregnancy and an STI? If those things are things you don't want, which most people don't want to get infections or pregnancy at a time they're not ready for it, do you know how to prevent it? Do you have access to birth control? Do you have access to social support? Do you have access to the right sexual information, not the stuff that's shared around the locker room? If a pregnancy were to occur, do you have a plan on how you would react? There are many people who have different views on abortion or adoption, and whatever your views may be, it is good to plan ahead. If I choose to have sex, can I plan for a pregnancy? Am I emotionally ready to give up that child for adoption, raise that child, or get an abortion? All three of those things are very emotionally straining. So, would you be ready to do that if the need arose? And fourth, do you feel like you are mature enough to have a very frank conversation with someone about your sexual needs, your sexual wants, and your sexual limits? Do you feel like you'd be able to say no? Or be able to say, hey, can we do this later? Or can you say the word penis or vagina in front of your significant other? Do you feel comfortable doing that? If not, you're probably not ready for sex. Sex is an adult thing. Your body becomes an adult, but sometimes your brain needs some catching up. If you can't have those mature conversations, it might be good to wait to have sex until you are. And last but not least, whoever your significant mother may be, do you feel like that person respects your boundaries? Even if you might be ready for sex some of the time, doesn't mean you're ready for sex all of the time. So when you say, again, can we do this later? Or can we do this in a different way? Or, hey, this is uncomfortable for me. Can we readjust? Do you feel like you can have that conversation with that person? And do you feel like that person would respect those boundaries? Thanks again so much for watching. We worked hard on these videos, and please take a look at all those other videos that we worked on. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. All of my resources are down in the comments or in the description for this video. So take a look at those, and I've also added some additional resources for those who might be curious. Again, thanks so much for watching. Give it a like and subscribe, and we'll see you later.